Nearly 1 billion pesos. That's how much the Philippine Land Transportation Office collected in penalties from traffic violators in the first half of the year. According to LTO data, over 330,000 motorists were apprehended in the six-month period. This has so far resulted in over 986 million pesos in collected fines. LTO Chief Vigor Mendoza expects this number to increase since some apprehended drivers have yet to settle their fines. The LTO aims to collect 33 billion pesos this year from the motor vehicle user charges and driver's license transactions. The bickering between Philippine Senators Nancy Binay and Alan Peter Cayetano continues. Binay is bent on pursuing the ethics complaint she filed against Cayetano over his, quote, abusive remarks during the hearing into the new Senate building project. This, as she says, she sees no remorse from Cayetano.
As a senior statesman, hindi dapat nangyari, hindi dapat niya ginawa yon. So, I am also protecting the institution. And at the same time, nanay din ako, isa akong magulang. Can you just imagine, pag balik sa eskwelahan ng mga anak ko, pwedeng may magsabi sa kanila na, oh, yung nanay mo pala, sira ulo, kasi si Senator Alan, tinawag siyang buang. Nagbitaw na ng salita si Majo na a-actionan niya itong complaint natin. And hopefully, talagang masunod yung proseso pagdating dun sa pag-hear dito sa complaint.
Cayetano, meanwhile, is not backing down and has even doubled down by threatening to file his own ethics complaint. As for the chair of the Senate Ethics Committee, Senator Francis Tolentino, he says he does not want to prejudge his colleagues. He also vows his committee's impartiality in handling the complaint.
We have a vibrant democracy in action, although some would perhaps judge some of the words as unparliamentary. Let's leave it to the committee to decide. First, I have yet to fully organize the committee. I still have one member missing yet. Mm-hmm. So we'll have it fully organized probably next week at the earliest, because some of my colleagues are still out of town. Mm-hmm. And we're supposed to reconvene on the 22nd of July. Mm-hmm. So, and then thereafter, following the rules, we will have to make a preliminary determination as to whether the committee should take the institution has to be held in high esteem, dignified. But let's see. We're not yet conducting a hearing. I would encourage you to cover the hearing.
Media company Reliance Broadcasting set to roll out its direct-to-home service after securing the necessary license from Philippine telecom regulators. That means the Pampanga-based firm can now broadcast free-to-air channels to remote areas in the Philippines. RBU will soon be deploying set-top boxes for those who are interested in availing its services. The DTH service will be powered by Korea's satellite communications leader, KTSAT. The firm is also in talks with key organizations to air public service announcements and educational materials for the Filipino public.